Explain.
Solar water heater, solar panel. You've seen the solar panel where they heat the coil.
Okay.
And this is a pump which you can see in the fish tank.
Okay.
For now, no sunlight is there. That's why I'm just using, for no sunlight is there, so I'm just using a pump over here for the water to just come. But this is actually a real water which you keep in the water. You keep in the sun, the water is not heating. But now the water is not boiling. It's just a bubble. So you keep in the sun, then it becomes hot.
It's a bubble.
What is it used for, the great bath?
This is the Harappan people bath.
Harappan time.
Yes.
It was that Harappan civilization you are explaining.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it's a bio. Yeah,
I'm going to tell about biosphere.
What is it? Bio?
Biosphere is a global ecology system. All living beings, including their relationships with the elements of biosphere, hydrosphere, and atmosphere. Biosphere is divided into regions called biomes. They are for aquatic, forest, desert, tundra, and grassland. Second official classification of biosphere is ecosystem. It contains both biotic factors such as animals and plants and abiotic factors such as oxygen, nitrogen, and carbon dioxide. Third official classification of biosphere is common. It turns about biotic factors such as predators and sources of food. Fourth organization classification of a biosphere is population. Fifth organization classification of biosphere is organism. Industrial resources causes a significant adverse effect on the planet's biosphere. Human activities such as deforestation causes the accelerated extinction of species in forests due to population. Human demand for resources and these leaves less for other organisms. To avoid these factors, we should use three R's, that is, reduce, reuse, and recycle, and save our precious mother.
You can see it on YouTube.
Sir, these are the Harappan civilization galleries. These are 73.15 light and 23.5 white. These are used to save the surface pulses in the sun.
I heard the light.
environment, okay.
Environment means it is the sum or total of living beings and non-living beings. Non-living beings is also a part of our environment. Environment are two types, natural environment and social environment. Natural environment are lake, ponds, seas, mountains are all of natural environment. Social environment are houses, industries, hospitals are all of social man-made environment.
The generator, a coil of copper spins between two magnets and an electrical field is converted into DC current. DC current passes through an electrical rectifier and it's converted into AC current. AC current is a typical household uses.
In the office? In the office.
That's all.
Okay.
It gets in the magnet, it will rise.
All same. All same.
This is the coinage of our India. These are British coins, and these two coins are Mughal coins. Mughal rulers coins, these two coins.
Which is the Mughal?
These two Mughal rulers coins. And these coins are ordinary 5 rupees coins, but you can see some different pictures there. That this man, you can see Lal Bahadur Shastri in there. During his 100th birthday, they left this coin. And you can see a lady standing here. She is called Saint Alphonse. She is her 100th birthday is celebrated here, and they left this coin. And here is the pioneer Annadurai. We recently celebrated this birthday. And Rabindranath Tagore, he is a man to write our national anthem. And this is a really interesting coin. You can see 4 people standing here. This states that a small family is always a happy family. And these are some ANA coins. You can see a hole in this coin. You can see a hole in this coin. This coin is known as the Pakistan coin of one piece.
Okay.
And these are some ANA coins. This is 2 ANAs. And this is a Ceylon, Sri Lankan coin, 5 cents. And this is a Portuguese rule. When Portuguese came and ruled our India, these coins have been introduced. Thank you.
Good morning, sir. I am Akim, and I am going to give an instruction about Indian Space Research Organization, that's ISRO. It's a one and only spaceport in India. That's they will be launching 2 vehicles, that's PSLV and GSLV. Two posters about that. Then, the main 3 satellites on agriculture and climatic conditions are the Jugan, SRMSat and VesselSat. The Jugan sat is developed in IIT of Kanpur. It's used to image the Earth closer in the tropical region. And the SRMSat, it's developed in Chennai SRM University, and it's used to know the rate of global warming and water level and this carbon dioxide.
What is that? You are doing a project on the history of the city of London.
The city of London? Yeah.
Sir, the history of the city of London dates back to 2000 years ago. But in this project, we see the history of London dating from 300 years ago.
Okay.
What is the location of London, the world map?
You see here, the London is located in the United Kingdom in Europe.
And this is the London in 1700s, and that is London in 1800s.
In 1700s, the London had no more population. Near the River Thames, there was a rich flora and fauna flourishing. But in 1800s, the cultivation began to increase, and the agricultural flourish was flourishing in the parts of London.
Origin of all the European explorers in the year 1492 to 1522.
Many voyages were undertaken, and explorers like Christopher Columbus and Vasco da Gama set out for new lands. Christopher Columbus saw North America and Magellan set for World Tour.
And there's the British Empire and there's the industrialization of London.
The British Empire, if you see, the Britain is right here in the middle. They conquer the nations of Africa, Saudi Arabia, India, Pakistan, Australia, North America. In 1850, this is by 1850s. Then comes the process of industrialization. Till the starting of 1850s, all the work was done with the help of manpower or muscles. But after 1850s, many machines came and it was introduced, and this era is known as industrialization. Then after industrialization, we see here.
Then there is the United Kingdom and this is the modern city of London as you see today.
United Nation, if you see the countries of Ireland, Scotland and England came together to form United Nation. The capital was chosen as London here. And it's the modern city of London as you see today. Now let's see a small video clip, sir. Small video clip you see.
Okay.
Ancient markets and famous bridges. It's arguably the financial capital of the world and home to over 11,000 people. Wait, what? 11,000? That's right, but the city of London is a different place from London. Though London is also known for its historical landmarks, modern skyscrapers, ancient markets, famous bridges, and is home to the government, royal family, and 7 million people. But if you look at a map of London crafted by a careful cartographer, that map will have a 1 square mile hole near the middle. It's here where the city of London lives inside the city, named London. Despite these confusingly close names, the two Londons have separate city halls and elect separate mayors who collect separate taxes to fund separate police who enforce separate laws. The mayor of the city of London has a fancy title, the Right Honorable, the Lord Mayor of London, to match his fancy outfit. He also gets to ride in a golden carriage and work in a guild hall, while the mayor of London has to wear a suit, ride a bike, and work in an office building. The city of London also has its own flag and its own crest, which is awesome and makes London's lack of either twice as sad. To top it off, the city of London gets to act more like one of the countries in the UK than just an oddly located city, for uniquely, the corporation that runs the city of London is older than the United Kingdom by several hundred years. So how did the UK end up with two Londons, one inside of the other? Because Romans. 2,000 years ago, they came to Great Britain, killed a bunch of Druids, and founded a trading post on the River Thames and named it Londinium. Being Romans, they got to work doing what Romans do, enforcing laws, increasing trade, building temples, public baths, roads, bridges, and a wall to defend their work. And it's this wall which is why the current city of London exists. For though the Romans came and the Romans went and kingdoms rose and kingdoms fell, the wall endured protecting the city within. And the city, governing itself and trading with the world, grew rich. 1,000 years after the Romans, yet still 1,000 years ago, when William the Conqueror came to Great Britain to conquer everything and begin modern British history, he found the city of London with its sturdy walls more challenging to defeat than farmers on open fields. So he agreed to recognize the rights and privileges city of Londoners were used to in return for them recognizing him as the new king. Though after the negotiation, William quickly built towers around the city of London, which were just as much about protecting William from the locals within as defending against the Vikings from without. He started a 1,000-year-long tradition whereby monarchs always reconfirmed that, yes, the city of London is a special, unique place that's best left to its own business, while simultaneously distrusting it. Many monarchs thought the city of London was too powerful and rich, and one even built a new capital city nearby, named Westminster, to compete with the city of London and hopefully suck power and wealth away from it. This was the start of the second London. As the centuries passed, Westminster grew and merged with nearby towns, eventually surrounding the walled-in and still separate city of London. But people began to call the whole urban collection London, and the name became official when Parliament joined the towns together under a single municipal government with a mayor. But the mayor of London still doesn't have power over the tiny city of London, which has rules and traditions like nowhere else in the country and possibly the world. For example, the ruling monarch doesn't just enter the city of London, but instead asks for permission from the Lord Mayor at a ceremony. While it's not required by law, the ceremony is unusual, to say the least. The city of London also has a representative of Parliament, the Remembered Sir, whose job it is to protect the city's special rights. Because of this law, as my Parliament sometimes don't apply to the city of London, most notably voting reform laws, which we'll discuss next time. But if you're curious for a preview, unlike anywhere else in the UK, elections in the city of London involve medieval guilds and modern companies. Finally, the city of London also owns and operates land and buildings far outside its border, making it quite wealthy. Once you start looking for the city's best, you'll find it in lots of unexpected places, most notably on Tower Bridge, which, while being in London, is operated by the city of London. These crests everywhere, when combined with the city of London's age and wealth and quasi-independent status, make it an irresistible temptation for conspiracy nuts. Add in the old Masonic temple, and it's not long before the crazy part of the internet starts yelling about secret societies which run the world by the finance industry from inside the city-state of London. And don't forget the reptilian alien queen, who's really behind it all. But conspiracy conspiracy theories aside, the city of London is not an independent nation like the Vatican is, no matter how much you might read it on the internet. Rather, it's a unique place in the United Kingdom with a long and very complicated history. The wall that began all this 2,000 years ago is now mostly gone, so the border between London and its secret inner city isn't so obvious. Though, next time you're in London, if you come across a small dragon on the street, he still guards the entrance to the city in a country in a country. Thank you.